because they have made up for your absence, or they refresh my spirit as well as yours. Give recognition to such men. The churches of Asia can send greetings. Aquila and Prisca, together with the church in your house, send your hearty greetings in the Lord. All the brethren in greetings, greet one another with your holy kiss. I, Paul, write this greeting with my own hand. If and only has no love for the Lord, let it be accursed. Our Lord come, the grace of the Lord Jesus be with you. My love be with you all. And Christ Jesus, amen.
Peace be with you, and your grace, and thank you also.
Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures
The very stone which the builders rejected has become the head of the corner. This was the Lord's glory, and it was marvelous in our eyes.
Glory to you, Lord. Glory to you.
Oh,
Virgin, and with all your people. For the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your holy, good and mighty Spirit, now and forever, created of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with all of you, we pass.
Oh. Oh.
confident before you in my judgment on the nation.
Thank you.
Today's parable told to us by our Lord Jesus Christ, after his entry into Jerusalem on Palm Sunday. This parable was told not to the crowds of people, but to the chief priests and the Pharisees. In the parable, Jesus talks about a householder who planted a vineyard, lent it out to tenants, and went into another country. Thus, householder is God, the creator of the world. The vineyard is the world. The tenants are the Jewish people, the people of God, chosen to tend his vineyard. The chief priests and the Pharisees are the leaders, those most responsible for spreading God's word among the Jewish people. The use of the word tenant is intentional. The temporal elite had some sense of almost ownership of the temple, as if it was theirs, and that it ceased being God's. A tenant is not an owner and not permanent. No one is permanent. Even owners are not permanent. Life for all of us is temporary. The season of the fruits refers to harvesting what God has planted. God planted seeds of love when he created the world. He hoped to receive matured love from his tenants. When he went to the house of love he had sown, he did so by sending his servants to the tenants. The servants were the prophets, people like Moses, Elijah, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Daniel, and John the Baptist. The Jewish leadership had a hard time acquiescing to the authority of the prophets and treated the prophets poorly. The Lord sent more servants, more prophets, a steady line of prophets from the time of Abraham until the time of Jesus. No one could successfully turn the people to God and harvest the fruit of love. God then decided to send his son, as we hear in the parable, thinking that they will respect my son. Jesus continues in the parable, telling the priests how the tenants decided to kill the son. This was foreshadowing his own death, now only days away. He knew they were going to take him, throw him out of the temple, and kill him. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to the nation producing the fruit of it. This was a warning that the kingdom of heaven will go to the responsible tenants who have honored the Lord's vineyard and have produced for him a harvest of love. And this nation was not only the Jewish nation, but any nation, Jewish or Gentile, that produced a harvest of love for God and for neighbor. The lesson of this parable at this time was an indictment of the Jewish leadership and an invitation to the Gentiles to be responsible and faithful tenants of the vineyard. The lesson for today is that we are tenants in God. God's field, each of us has a vineyard and a supply of grapes to harvest. We are to harvest them using our unique talents and gifts. We are to harvest others for the Lord. And we are to harvest love in and with those around us. My beloved brothers and sisters, be good tenants in your vineyard today. Amen. Next weekend is the weekend commemorating on Monday the great feast of the veneration and the exaltation of the Holy Cross. Services were scheduled for that day, but in view of the fact that parishioners will be scarce on Monday morning, as you see today, on Sunday. So therefore, the service of the cross will be conducted next Sunday, following the Divine Liturgy, and will be omitted on Monday, and will be conducted again the following Sunday for those that will be in church as well. The Eucharistia is in sources used of group. Good morning, have a beautiful weekend, enjoy tomorrow, your neighbor.